Mattingly, and I'm a senior at Chris Chadwick School Academy, and my presentation is on connectivity and social media. The average human's attention span is now 1 second less than that of a goldfish. According to the National Center for Biotechnology Information, our attention spans have, quote, dropped from 12 seconds in 2000 to 8 seconds in 2013. They attribute this lack of attention to an increase in external stimulation. A very probable source of the stimulation is social media sites, which first became popular around the year 2000. Because, quote, the ability to focus attention on a task is crucial for the achievement of one's goals, an unoriginal but rarely employed way of life should be preferred to the hectic, busybody lifestyle that produces a small attention span. This lifestyle recognizes that there is a time for being engaged and a time for being disengaged with the world so as to be fully engaged with one's duties and one's need for leisure. A small but crucial step towards this way is this. The use of social networking sites by youth should be minimized and should not be the primary means to connect with others. Since these sites are directed towards connectivity and communication, what is communication? The dictionary definition is rather simple. Quote, the exchange of thoughts, messages, or the like, as by speech, signals, or writing, end quote. However, there is a great deal more to it than that, as the National Communication Association describes it as, quote, a diverse discipline which includes inquiry by social scientists, humanists, and critical and cultural studies scholars, end quote. Clearly, communication is a complex matter, and even more so when social media comes into play. The first social site actually arrived earlier than one might think. In 1978, two computer hobbyists from Chicago invented the bulletin board system on which one can make announcements and share news with friends through postings. 1997 was the year chat bars were introduced. Chat bars, notably, are still used today in modern social networking sites. In 1999, Friend Reunited was launched in Great Britain. 3 years later, Friendster was launched. In 2003, MySpace and Second Life were introduced. Then came Facebook in 2004, which would become the most popular site of all by far. Another site that is almost as popular is Twitter, which was presented in 2006. By 2013, social media sites in various forms were appearing everywhere. Social sites ought to be used minimally by youth and not be the primary means to connect with others, because they have the potential to pose not only communication difficulties, but also problems of all kinds. For one, messages through social sites are often obscured. Additionally, these sites are often addictive. Browsing through the many posts and pictures of others can create feelings of discontentment. Immorality, both personal and impersonal, is an ever-present temptation to the youth who use these sites, as well as to all people. Furthermore, sexual predators and stalkers control virtual communities to find victims. Lastly, cyberbullying is also made possible with online communication. On a social site, the emotion and potentially the meaning with which a message is intended is more often than not obscured when using merely words. Father Jonah Lynch stated specifically about chat bars, quote, chat creates a distance which isn't there in other forms of long-distance communication, end quote. The distance he is referring to is a distance that is created with the lack of human contact through the senses, which enable one to interpret the feelings of another when two or more interact with each other. The distance and misunderstanding that can develop from chat bars can be avoided, but not as simply as one would like. Additionally, social networking sites are often addictive. This is due to the many entertaining videos, pictures, and memes, which are humorous videos, images, and pieces of text that can be found and posted on these sites. Interestingly, quote, 36% of people surveyed listed social networking as the biggest waste of time. The percentage was even higher than fantasy sports, television, and shopping. Most likely, this is because these sites include each of the main useless aspects of these three things: virtual productivity, excessive screen viewing, and ever-present advertisements. Addiction to using social media sites is one way in which a person is unable to live a healthy lifestyle. There are several problems that may come with any addiction. Impulsiveness, loneliness, and depression are a few of them. These are serious problems, and sadly, social networking can be the cause of them when they are overused. As was stated previously, social networking sites are very easy to overuse, owing to the many bells and whistles they come with, like entertaining videos, pictures, memes, and the ability to talk with friends. However, many people, when they begin to use these sites, use them wisely, and they may continue to do so if they understand that social sites will not fulfill the human need for relationships. Still, there are some individuals, particularly young ones, who do not understand this, at least not completely. This may pose a problem as, quote, the effect of technology depends on the person, not on the technology, end quote. David Grisman goes on to say that, quote, the less social the person already is, the more that technology can cause problems, end quote. This is why when younger people who have not developed their personality yet and who have not discovered who they are in relation to others use these sites, they may be doing more harm than good, as he or she may feel unable to live without them. It's important to realize that, quote, it is also the technology that uses its user. This is where the addictive aspect is evident. For example, the user may find himself impulsively checking Facebook during a free moment instead of spending some quiet time with a family member. Furthermore, the socially insecure person might believe the lie that if he has more friends or followers, then he will have more worth and will be more connected. This will drive him to spend sometimes endless hours on these sites, at the same time alienating himself from the people directly in his life. Also, even though one will be more connected if he has more friends or followers, it will only be of a shallow form, not in the deep way that is required for healthy relationships. Sherry Turkle stated, quote, our network life allows us to hide from each other, even as we are tethered to each other, end quote. As one becomes hooked on these sites, one oftentimes experiences a feeling of disconnect. Clifford Stoll seems to lay out the case bluntly when he says this in his article, quote, what's missing from this election?